Assalamu alaikum. In the last lecture, we studied about some features of angle modulation, that angle modulated waves are immune to non-linearities. We also solved some numericals regarding angle modulated waves. After that, we studied a method for generation of FM waves. The method that we studied was the indirect method of Armstrong. In that method, there were few steps in which first we produced narrow band frequency modulated wave, and then step by step we increased its frequency by using frequency multiplier till we got our required waveform. Today we will also study methods of generation of FM wave and method for demodulation of FM waves. In the first part, we will study the method for the direct generation of FM waves, that how can we directly generate FM waves without using different multipliers. This method is an alternate method to the indirect method of Armstrong, and this method is known as the direct generation method. So, in this method, we will use the voltage controlled oscillator, which will be operated by external voltage. So we know that voltage controlled oscillator, in the voltage controlled oscillator, the frequency is controlled by an external voltage. The initial frequency is given as omega it, and the carrier frequency is given by omega c. Kf is constant, and that is representing frequency modulated signal as a constant for frequency modulated signal, and m of t is our original signal. We construct a circuit of voltage controlled oscillator by using operational amplifier and a comparator. We will use a reversed bias semiconductor diode to design this circuit, where the capacitance of semiconductor diode will be used, as we know that its capacitance will be varied by using different biasing voltage. So we know that the frequency in non-linear devices can be given as omega naught is equal to 1 over under root LC, and the frequency, the equation of frequency modulated wave in which frequency has to be varied, the equation for frequency is given as omega it is equal to omega c plus kf mt. So now we will derive the equation for how we can generate FM waves. Suppose that the original capacitance of the device before applying external voltage is given as C, and it is varied by the input by applying the signal. So the equation will be written as C is equal to C naught minus KMT. It means that when we applied the external voltage to the voltage controlled oscillator, its capacitance is varied. How the capacitance is varied? The change in capacitance is given as K into the change in capacitance is the difference between the original value and the voltage applied to the circuit. So if we use this equation then we can get the value like this: omega naught is equal to 1 over under root LC naught common 1 minus KMT over C naught. One step is missing here, because when we will put the value here, it will become the value of C will be C naught minus K into MT. So here will be L C naught minus K MT C naught. Then we will take L C naught common from here, which will be inside the square root. Then this equation will become 1 minus K MT over C naught. So this equation can be simplified like this. If we just separate these two equations in the denominator, L C naught under root and 1 minus K MT over C naught 1 by 2, which will be nearly equal to 1 over L C naught under root into 1 plus K MT over 2 C naught. This calculation can only be made if it has been assumed that K MT over C naught is very very less than 1, because if K MT over C naught is less than 1, we can apply the formula of binomial expansion, in which 1 plus x raised to the power n can be nearly equal to 1 plus nx if the value inside is less than 1. So we will apply the binomial expansion, and this expression will be equal to this expression. Now we know that omega naught is equal to omega c plus omega c into 1 plus k mt over 2 c naught. How we have derived this equation? It's because we know the value of omega from here, and we can just put the value of omega from this equation to here. So it will be omega naught is equal to omega c plus, here it has been used omega naught, and here we have used omega c. It has been used to differentiate between the two values, because 1 over L C naught will be equal to omega c, and omega naught is equal to 1 over L C under root. To differentiate omega naught from omega c, we have used omega c here, and here we have also written that omega c is equal to 1 over L C naught. And if we assume that K omega c over 2 C naught is equal to KF, then we can replace this whole thing. K omega c over C naught with KF into MT. If you multiply omega c inside this bracket, this expression will become omega naught is equal to omega c plus K omega c MT over 2 C naught. K C naught over K omega c over 2 C naught is equal to KF. If we assume, then this expression will become omega c plus KF MT, which is equal to this expression, the change in frequency. Now this expression is the normal expression for generating the FM wave, but we will also derive the expression if the capacitance deviation is maximum. So we know that C is equal to C naught minus K M of T. For the maximum capacitance, the maximum value of M of T is MT. We know that peak value, and the rate of change of capacitance can be calculated if we take the C naught here. It will be equal to C minus C naught is equal to minus K M of T. So the original value minus final value C naught minus C will be equal to delta C. So delta C is equal to K into MT. We have used MT because we are using the maximum value for capacitance deviation on the right left hand side, so that the maximum value of the signal will be used on the right hand side. So delta C is equal to K MT from this equation, and after that we can use the value here 2KF C naught MT over MT over omega C. By just putting the value of K from here. We know that K is equal to 2 C naught KF, over omega c. So by using the value of k from here, delta c will be written like this. Or if you want to calculate the ratio can be given as delta c over c naught is equal to 2kf mp over omega c. So let me repeat the mathematical calculation for the direct method of generation of FM waves. We know that in angle modulation the frequency is varied, and how frequency is varied, the equation is omega it is equal to omega c plus kf mt. Practically in this circuit we use semiconductor diode in reverse bias, and we use the value of its capacitance, and we know that the value of frequency in these kind of devices can be given as omega naught is equal to 1 over under root LC. And if the capacitance is varied by the modulated signal, or if we apply the voltage on the terminals of voltage control oscillator, the equation will be equal to C is equal to C naught minus K M of T. It's because the capacitance is varied, and how much capacitance is varied, that is given by K M of T. As we know that if frequency is varied, it is given by this. If capacitance is varied, it will be given by this. So by using this equation, by putting the value of C from here to here, it will be equal to omega naught is equal to 1 over LC naught minus LC KMT. We will take LC naught common, then the expression will be like this. By doing some mathematical calculation, it will be like this, and by using the binomial expression approximation and assuming that KMT over C naught is very very less than 1, we can write it as omega naught is equal to omega C into 1 plus KMT over 2 C naught, where omega C is equal to this is actually the expression. Now we are only changing its form, as we assume that 1 over LC naught can be equal to omega C, and this expression can be equal to KF is equal to K omega C over 2 C naught. So these are just different forms. And for the maximum capacitance deviation, we will use we will take C naught here. C naught minus C will be the change in capacitance, and KMP, MP is representing the maximum peak value. So we can calculate ratio by taking C naught here. So this is the mathematical expression for the direct method of generation for FM waves. Usually delta F over delta C is very small, and delta C is a small fraction of C naught, which helps us limit the harmonic distortion that arises because of all the approximations in this kind of derivation. Now we will study about the demodulation of FM waves. The demodulation of FM waves is not very complex, it is rather simple. We apply the input the signal FM of t, which is the frequency modulated signal, to the ideal differentiator. In the ideal differentiator, if we take the differentiation of the signal, it will be like a omega c plus kf mt sine omega c t plus kf minus infinity to t m of alpha d of alpha. Graphically this signal can be represented, this process can be represented like this. If phi fm of t is applied to the differentiator, then the signal will be in this form, and after the signal is in this form, we can apply the envelope detector to get the our original signal. But to have this process successfully, we need to have the amplitude of the signal constant. So how can we remove the variation in amplitude? Because by different distortions, the amplitude of the signal can be varied slightly, but to have this process efficiently, we need to have the value of amplitude constant. So we use a special process to maintain the constant value of amplitude. That process is known as bandpass limiter, because the amplitude variations of angle modulated carrier is not required in the frequency modulated signal. So we need to eliminate the amplitude variations. So how can we eliminate the amplitude variation? We use a bandpass filter, which is also known as the complete bandpass filter includes a portion known as hard limiter. So what does this limiter do? The purpose of this circuit is to remove all the amplitude variations in the frequency modulated signal. As we see that the frequency modulated signal can be given in this form. Here we see that the solid lines is representing the frequency modulated signal. The amplitudes of the waves are different. In order to have perfect demodulation, we need to have its amplitude constant. So to keep its amplitude constant, we pass this signal through a wave like this, which is provided as we will pass the signal through the hard limiter and the bandpass limiter, and after that we will get an output like this, which is the output has been given in dotted form here, and here the complete output has been provided. So how can we do this process? The input output characteristic has been given in the diagram. It is rather simple, and mathematically how we do it: the input voltage, the input angle modulated wave is given as Vi of t is equal to At cos theta t, where theta t contains our original signal, omega ct plus kf minus theta minus infinity to t m of alpha d alpha. We know that m of alpha is our original signal. The output of the hard limiter is rather plus 1 or minus 1. We know that from here, the value, if cos theta is greater than 0, the value is 1, and if cos theta is less than 0, the value is minus 1. The hard limiter has been given in the figure 5.12b. This figure gives us the hard limiter, and V naught is the function of a periodic square wave with the period of 2 pi, which can be expanded in the Fourier series. V naught is equal to 4 by pi cos theta minus 1 by 3 cos 3 theta plus 1 by 5 cos 5 theta. We have actually studied this kind of wave before in fourth chapter when we were studying non-linear modulators. We used this kind of waveforms before, and we see that if we apply this kind of limiter to our original signal, we will get, mathematically we will get this form: 4 by pi cos omega ct plus kf infinity minus m of alpha d alpha minus 1 by 3 cos 3 omega ct plus kf infinity m of alpha d alpha plus 1 by 5 and so on. But we know that we only want our original signal, so we will use band pass filter centered at omega c, and we will get a waveform like this. We know that this value of 4 by pi is just a constant and it can be removed. So we can get our original signal back. So it means that before using the demodulation, we should use band pass limiter to get the amplitude constant, and then we can apply demodulation process. Thank you.